so far I've just let them do the tutorials on their own, and that's been very effective. I've let one student work on it, and then a couple more students would come along and watch what was going on, and then a couple more and a couple more. So even yesterday, there were about 8 students all gathered around, quietly and patiently watching as the action unfolded. We're planning on using one of the tutorials that comes with the Hour of Code on the Hour of Code website. Mm-hmm. And I plan on having each student work about maybe half hour at a time on the tutorials. I don't want to make it last the whole hour for such a young audience, because I think it might be too much. So far we've been working about 15 minutes during lunch recess, and that's been working very well. I think the most important thing is that the interest is really there, and that they're really eager and willing to learn at this age about what's going on and about how to program. And it's inspiring to see that in action. It's really fun to watch, just to step back and watch them do it on their own. They really are motivated and willing to learn. And it's good also to step in just once in a while if they get stuck and maybe guide them a little bit. My son was really curious at an early age, and so I fed that, and we would stop by the roadsides and pick up microwave ovens and bring them home and take them apart, and it just led to his curiosity. In eighth grade, he took my freshman year programming class, because I had no place to put him for a period, so before he went to middle school, he would come to my class when I was teaching driver's ed at the high school. And he worked his way through the freshman programming class and did very well. He then went on and took AP Computer Science and Web Dev, and went on and got accepted at UC Berkeley. He's now in his final year at UC Berkeley in the Electrical Engineering Computer Science program. And he got an internship at Google. So I'm thinking, if that's possible with the work that I spent with him, it's certainly possible at the elementary school to get these kids at least interested. I think it's really important to reach out to the girls, because they don't typically get experience like this. And it's wonderful to see at this age, they don't get the feeling that this is for boys. I never get that feeling. Whereas by the time you get to high school, it's definitely much more polarized, and much more boys are interested in taking computer science classes than girls. So my goal is to hopefully motivate more girls into going into computer science.